girls to our first Black History program here at Park Forest Elementary Creative Sciences and Arts Magnet. You know who I am. I'm Miss Mitchell, but I want to introduce myself to you as your principal. I would like to welcome you to our virtual program because, of course, COVID is a thing, but we will not let it stop our education. Here at Park Forest, we believe in cultivating success in our academic, social, and character development. Therefore, we have to keep the education going. Today, you're going to learn a few things from some very important people. And you will also learn about a little culture also. Please make sure you look out for our choir because they are dynamic and we know that they're the best in the city. So we are here to introduce to you the Black History Program for our school. The program is about to start, so boys and girls all around.
Get your bodies ready now.
Absolutely, get your bodies ready for our Black History Program. I am so excited and I know that you are too. Sit back, relax, and enjoy as we take a ride through history and bring it forward to the future. Enjoy and good night.
Joshua hit the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua hit the battle of Jericho. The walls came tumbling down, hallelujah. Joshua hit the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua hit the battle of Jericho and walls came tumbling down. You may talk about the men of Gideon, you may talk about the men of Saul, but they're not like the good old Joshua. The battle of Jericho, hallelujah. Joshua fought the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua fought the battle of Jericho and the wolf came tumbling down, hallelujah. Joshua fought the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua fought the battle of Jericho and the wolf came tumbling down. Battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua fought the battle of Jericho and wolf came tumbling down that morning. Joshua fought the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua fought the battle of Jericho and the wolf came tumbling down, hallelujah. Joshua fought the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua fought the battle of Jericho and the wolf came tumbling down.
I became the first African American woman to become a millionaire who earned my own fortune. I am Madam C.J. Walker. I was born in Louisiana in 1867 with the name of Sarah Boone. My parents were former slaves. Though slavery had been outlawed, by the time I was born, I did not have an easy life because my parents died when I was 7. I had to pick cotton to survive. I also did not know how to read. While working hard to take care of myself and my daughter, my hair started falling out. This turned to be a good thing. I wasn't happy about losing my hair, and I tried a lot of different curls before I found one called the Gray Wonderful Hair Girl, made by another African American woman. It worked really, really well, and I liked it so much that I had to start selling it. In 1905, I moved to Denver. I married a man named Charles Joseph Walker, making me Mrs. C.J. Walker, and I became an entrepreneur. I made my own hair color, Madam Walker's Wonderful Hair. I took the name Madam because it gave me product for Ric Flair. I became the first African American woman to become a millionaire who earned my own fortune.
Johnson. I was born in White Sulphur Springs, West Virginia in 1918. I was the youngest of four children. I grew up in a time when people of color, especially women, were limited in their careers. And this limitation extended to education as well. Public schools did not allow students of color to attend beyond eighth grade. Can you believe that? But from the time I was young, I loved learning, especially mathematics, and I was very good at it. My mother was a teacher, and my family was supportive of continuing education.
I am the greatest! Ain't I pretty? I'm Muhammad Ali. I was born on January 17th, 1942, in Louisville, Kentucky. My original name was Cassius Clay. That's the name my mother gave me. At the age of 18, I won a gold medal at the Olympic Games in Rome. I became the world heavyweight champion in 1964. In 1964, I joined the Nation of Islam and changed my name to Muhammad Ali. At the time, the United States was fighting the Vietnam War. In 1967, I refused to join the armed forces because of my religion. I was convicted of breaking the law and my title was taken from me and I was not allowed to box. The United States Supreme Court overturned my conviction. In March 1971, I challenged Joe Frazier to a fight. Frazier was the current heavyweight champion. I lost that match but later defeated Frazier. By then, however, Frazier had lost the title to George Foreman. In the match against Foreman in 1974, I regained my world heavyweight title. I held the title until 1978. In 1979, I announced that I would retire. Some of my famous phrases are, I float like a butterfly. I sting like a bee. I died on June 3rd, 2016 in Phoenix, Arizona. I am the greatest.
Sometimes you need to get kicked down to understand what you're fighting.
Hello, I'm Chadwick Boseman. I was born November 29, 1976, and I died August 28, 2020 from colon cancer. I was an American playwright. I landed my first major role. I achieved international fame for playing Black Panther, Wakanda Forever. My final film, My Rank, Black Bottom, was released after my death. I donated to many charities privately that supported disadvantaged children.
In every nook of our nation, in every corner called our country, our people, diverse and beautiful, will emerge battered and beautiful. When day comes, we step out of the shade, aflame and unafraid. The dawn blooms as we free it, for there is always light. If only we're brave enough to see it. If only we're brave enough to be it. Hello, my name is Amanda S.C. Gorman. I'm the youngest inaugural poet in U.S. history, as well as an award-winning writer and graduate of Harvard University. I was born and raised in Los Angeles, California. I began writing at only a few years of age. I was appointed the first ever National Youth Poet by Urban Word. I published the poet book, The One Home Food Is Not Enough, in 2015. In 2021, I delivered my poem, The Hill We Climb, at the inauguration of President Joe Biden.
I'm Louis Dane Armstrong. Some people call me Satchel, Satch and Pops. I was born August 4th, 1901 in New Orleans, Louisiana. I'm a trumpeter, band leader, singer, soloist, film star, and comedian. In the 1920s, I influenced countless musicians with trumpeting style and unique vocals. My charismatic stage presence impress not only the jazz world, but all of popular music. I was known for songs like Stardust and What a Wonderful World. I died at my home in Queens, New York on July 6, 1971.
Challenges make you discover things about yourself that you never really knew.
Hi, I'm Cicely Tyson. I was born December 19, 1924 in Harlem, New York City. I died January 28, 2021 at the age of 96. I was a famous actress and fashion model. I was known for my portrayal of strong African-American women. I received 3 Primetime Emmy Awards and 4 Black Reel Awards, 1 Screen Actors Award, Guy Award, 1 Tony Award, and Harley Academic Award, and a Peabody Award. In November 2016, I received the Presidential Medal of Freedom, which is the highest civilian honor in the United States.
I am inventor and engineer Otis F. Boykin. I was born on August 29, 1920. I am best known for making improvements to the pacemaker. I am also famous for inventing electronic control devices for guided missiles, IBM computers, resistors, and televisions. My invention made these products more affordable. Overall, I have 26 patents.
Was an educator in the Chicago school system. She was concerned that with the fact that many students needed more attention in school. So she started her own. She named the school Collins Home, focused on reading, math, language skills, and discipline. Many of my students were considered to have learning disabilities. With the help of me, most of my students finished high school and graduated from college.
What's up, everybody? My name is James West. I am a research professor at Johns Hopkins University. I also worked at Bell Laboratories when I partnered with Jared Caesar to develop a small and highly sensitive microphone. My invention was patented in 1962. To this date, 90% of all microphones, which include those cell phones, laptops, baby monitors, and hearing aids, use the technology that was developed by me.
I'm Octavius V. Cattle, and I'm an educator. I challenged laws that prevented African Americans from riding railways, attending non-segregated schools, and voting. My family was healthy, so I was never a slave. As a matter of fact, I was gifted as a child and attended the best schools for African Americans. As an adult, I assisted the colored troops in the Civil War. Later, I returned to my true love, teaching. To this day, my determination is one of the reasons so many people are allowed to vote today.
Born in 1871, James Weldon Johnson was an American author, educator, lawyer, and civil rights activist. Johnson established his reputation as a writer and was known during the Harlem Residence for his poems, novels, and anthologies, collecting both poems and spirituals of Black culture. Lift Every Voice and Sing, known also as the Black National Anthem, was written as a poem by James Weldon Johnson while in leadership of the NAACP, and then set to music by his brother John Rosamond Johnson in 1899. It was first performed in public in the brothers' hometown of Jacksonville, Florida, as part of their celebration of Lincoln's birthday on February 12, 1900. By a choir of 500 school children at the segregated Sandton School, where James Weldon Johnson was principal. And now, please stand for the Black National Anthem. Lift Every Voice and Sing. Thank you.
beach.
Big smile. Alright, put your head down when you smile.
Huh?
Put your head down when you smile. Okay. I'm gonna put that on you too, right there, okay?
No!
Okay, so we're gonna do it one more time, alright? You gotta be confident. Remember your teacher. Think about it. Your teacher, if they didn't project or be energetic, would you enjoy class?
Yep.
Go.
I became the first African American woman to become a millionaire who earned my own fortune.
I am Muhammad Ali.
Wait a minute. You don't know who you are?
I know, it's crazy.
I know. You gotta smile one more time and hold it. Alright, hold your trumpet up. Who earned my own fortune. Okay?
It's okay.
Yeah.
I became the first African American
woman
to become a millionaire who drank for fortune.
Hello everybody, my name is James.
Go back. Come on, confidence. Big smile. I said big smile. Cheese. Show some teeth. Really? Like, are you nervous? So, is he reading like he's nervous?
He said bite his man. He gonna see bite.
To this day, about 90% of all microphones, which include those in cell phones, laptops, baby monitors, and hearing aids, use the technology that developed by these men.
Challenges make you discover things about yourself that you really
That was good. All right, do it one more time.
Challenges make you
Come on, I need you to put emphasis on it. Challenges.
Challenges make you discover things about yourself that you really
That you never really know. I like how you say challenges, okay? Do it again. One, two, go. Hold on. Here, back is in this out.
They did say voting.
It's okay.
I challenge laws that prevented African Americans from riding with